Baby One More Time flying out of the stores, but she also just got her first two Grammy nominations this week. We'll talk to her and hear her sing in a few minutes. But first, a She sung her signature hit, Baby One More Time, more times than she can count. Teen singing sensation Britney Spears was barely a baby herself when she first hit the big time. At age 11, she followed in some famous paw prints as part of the Disney Channel's all-new Mickey Mouse Club. Britney hung up her mouse ears in 1994 to go back to high school, but the bright lights beckoned. She auditioned for an all-girl group and ended up snaring a solo deal with Jive Records. A massive marketing blitz made her the poster child for the teen scene even before she released her first single. The sight of her cavorting in a schoolgirl uniform, along with a bare midriff and some attitude, helped her zoom up the charts, becoming the youngest female in Billboard history to have her debut single and first album go to number one in the same week. A full year after its debut, Baby One More Time remains in Billboard's top 10 and has gone platinum 11 times over. But despite the fame and the awards, and being molded in plastic as a doll, Britney says she's still just a small-town girl who loves reading Jackie Collins novels in the tub. And no, we don't have a picture of that.
And first talent show when she was just 6 years old, and she hasn't stopped since, with awards from MTV and Billboard to her credit. But all of them might just pale compared to her two Grammy nominations that came just this week for Best New Artist and Best Female Pop Vocal Performance. Britney Spears, good morning. It's so good to have you here. Congratulations. What was your reaction when you got the nominations?
I was really just happy to be there and be part of the whole Grammy Association. So when he said my name, I was like, wow, it's just such an honor, seriously, to be nominated.
But with all the success, you must have known that there was a pretty good chance.
Well, of course there was hope in the back of my mind. We can all dream. But when he said my name, that's just like the reality. I called my mom and I was like, guess what? So I was really, really excited.
We all fantasize when we watch the Oscars, when we watch the Grammys. You know, I'd be up there and here's what my speech would be. And we all think about that. Have you thought about that, what it would be like?
Not yet. I haven't thought about what I would say. But I do. I need to make some time to think about that. But I'm going to be so nervous. Oh, my lordy. I'm going to be just... It's going to be fun.
We heard in Tony Perkins' piece that he aired in the last half hour, you said you're just a normal girl. You like to soak in the bathtub and read novels.
Oh, God, totally. When I have time off, that is my thing to do. Just get in the tub, do yoga, read books, totally.
Got to ask the question. Is there really going to be a date with Prince William?
Well, I don't like talking about that part of my life, but he's cute, though, isn't he?
He sure is.
I think so.
And you have the perfect name to go over there and go out with the Prince of Great Britain.
I don't know about that. Well, thank you. That would be nice.
Anyway, you're going to sing for us.
Yes, I'm going to sing for you guys.
The new song being?
From the Bottom of My Broken Heart.
From the Bottom of My Broken Heart. All right. Britney Spears, here she is, folks.
Somehow from the
you so much.
To sing the song that really launched her career, Britney Spears, who I think has changed clothes and brought some dancers in with her, with Baby One More Time. Tells me you guys have rehearsed this, because if you improvised all those steps so perfectly together, I'm real impressed. Done this before a few times?
Just once or twice.
All right, we're going to take a commercial break. When we come back, the audience might have some questions for Britney Spears, and so we'll let them ask them. We'll be right back. Very sweet, and that's tough. Spears and a very boisterous and enthusiastic crowd. You get this kind of audience reaction everywhere?
Most of the time. These are really good, though. To say.
Some of them are more boisterous?
Sometimes, yeah.
Is that right?
Wow.
No, there's a lot of very enthusiastic people. There's one young man in the crowd, I'm told, whose mother promised him if he got straight A's, she would bring him here.
Aww.
He did. He did get the straight A's, and she did bring him here. Well, and we also asked the audience if they had some questions for Ms. Spears. And Tony Perkins is with the audience.
Many, many questions. We'll start with Dana. Dana is from Brooklyn. What is your question?
Do you decide to do anything else when you grow up? Like acting or...
Does she do anything beyond singing her singing career?
Yeah.
when you grow up?
Well, right now I'm really busy focusing on the next album, and I'm really recording, and I have, you know, plans to tour like this whole year. But next year I would like just to experience in acting, you know, who knows, I don't know. But right now I'm really focused on my music, so I don't see that anytime
When does
soon.
The next album come out?
Sometime in the spring.
Okay. So. How long does it take to make an album?
It really depends. Right now I'm really, really busy. So actually 2 months ago I went to Sweden and I like recorded half the album in like a week and a half, which is kind of ridiculous because I'm just really, really busy. But most of the time, like my first album, it took me like 6 months.
Why Sweden?
That's where the producers are, like Max Martin.
Oh, that's good. Okay, Tony?
We have Kevin here. Kevin, you're from New Jersey?
Yes.
Kevin actually had a dream that he would meet you and get to talk to you. What's your question, Kevin?
Do you ever get scared while performing in front of thousands of people?
That's a good question. Do you?
Yes, I always get nervous, especially award shows, because I do a different performance every award show, and knowing that celebrities are out there and everything is kind of intimidating. So yes, I do get nervous.
When you have dancers a foot and a half from your left ear and they're kicking up over their head, do you get nervous that they might whap you?
No, they're really experienced, but no, I'm not worried about
that. They're terrific, actually. Go ahead, Tony.
Dan here. Dan, what did you want to ask Brittany?
Would you play at my school?
Would you play at Dan's school?
Did I what?
Would you play at Dan's school?
Yeah, sure.
That's very safe. Good. That's good.
They have a contract in his pocket. We got to be sure. What's your name?
Jeannie.
And what's your question?
How old were you when you started your career?
How old were you when you started your career?
Well, I started really taking it seriously, like being in a lot of competitions when I was like 8 years old. So
wow,
8
really?
Years old.
I started doing like a lot of competition events.
Is it a very musical family?
Really. On my mom's side in London, they play like, because her family's from London, they play a lot of instruments. But as far as vocally singing, no. So.
Okay. Anybody
else? Just out of curiosity, was this something you always wanted to do, or? Yeah. I know you took a break and you played.
Yes, ma'am. Ever since I was a baby, I've always been singing. So my mom would have company over, and they were always like, Lynn, are you going to tell her to be quiet? You know, I was just always everywhere, so.
And one more?
One more question. This is from Allison. Allison, what's your question?
How do you have time to go hang out with your friends, and what do you do in that time?
Yeah, when you're touring all the time and doing albums, when do you get time to hang out just with friends?
Well, I have the dancers on the road with me, so they're like my friends, and actually my friends from back at home, like I fly them every now and then when I'm on the road, like when I have like a weekend off, I'll fly them in and we'll just party and have fun. Like for my birthday, for instance, they came up and we had a blast.
Oh, neat. So.
You just turned 18, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Congratulations. Oh, happy birthday.
Yes, ma'am, she said.
You know, when somebody calls you ma'am, it's a little like, please,
I think
just
it's
say
Elizabeth. That's what my mom instilled in me, so.
All the best to you. Thanks very much for coming.
You.
It was a pleasure to have you.
Good
here.
Luck at the Grammys.
Thank you.
Yes, absolutely. Good luck. 8 to 4:09. Good Morning America continues. We'll be back.